Okay, everyone. We're all done reading each other's poems, right? I have something extra planned today, so everybody can come sit at the front of the room.
Oh, shit, I was too busy gabbing. Is this about the festival?
Well, sort of.
Ugh, do we really have to do something for the festival? It's not like we can put anything good together good in just a few days. We'll just end up embarrassing ourselves instead of getting any new members.
That's a concern of mine as well. I don't really do well with last minute preparations.
Don't worry so much. We're going to keep it simple, okay? We won't need much more than a few decorations. Sayori has been working on posters, and I designed some pamphlets we can give out during the event.
Okay, that's great, Neil. But that doesn't tell us what we're actually going to be doing for the event.
Oh, sorry, I thought you heard about it already. We're going to crash a plane.
That is cool.
We're going to be performing the plane scene.
Oh, that's poetry.
Yes, Lonnie.
Monica?
Yeah, we're going to be having a poetry performance.
Oh, shit. Did she not communicate with her group members?
Would it hurt if you took off the
mask? It would again if I was until I put on the mask.
You're a big guy!
For you. Each of us are going to choose a poem to recite during the event. But the cool part is, we're also going to let anyone else come up and recite poems too.
I'm sure everyone would love to do that.
Open mic slam poetry.
Yeah. Say, always put it on all the posters in case anyone wants to bear ahead of time.
You just gotta freestyle it.
Sayori, who's been coloring a poster, holds it up for us to see. It's just scribbles.
Are you kidding me, Mianica? You didn't, you didn't already start perking up those posters up, did you?
Well, I did. Do you really think it's that bad of an idea?
Well, no. It's not a bad idea. But I didn't sign up for this, you know. There is no way I'm going to be performing in front of a group of people like that.
I agree with Natsuki. I could never, in my life, do something like that.
Imagining it, Yuri shakes her head in fear.
Brennan vigorously shakes his head.
I don't want to do that.
Guys!
No, Sayori. I understand where they're coming from. Remember that Natsuki and Yuri had never shared their poems with anyone until just a couple of days ago. It's not to ask them to recite their poems out loud to a whole group of people. They merely adopted the poetry. I was born in it. Born to die. I guess I kind of overlooked that. So I'm sorry.
Yeah.
But I still think we should give it our best. We're the only ones responsible for the fate of this club.
She'd be a great politician.
If we start the event and each put on a good performance, then it will inspire others to do the same. And as such, the fire will rise. Gotham will burn. And the more people who perform, the better we'll be able to show everyone what literature is all about.
Yeah! It's about expressing your feelings. Being intimate with yourself. Oh my
green
god!
Green curtain
alarm.
Finding new horizons. And having fun.
But not too much fun.
That's right. And it's those reasons that we're all in this club today. Don't you want to share that with others? To inspire them to find the same feelings that brought you here in the first place. I know you do. I know we all do. And if all it takes is standing in front of a room for 2 minutes and reciting a poem, then I know you can do it.
Natsuki and Yuri remain silent. Sayori looks worried. I guess that leaves me no choice.
Oh no.
I agree. I don't think it's too much to ask.
Fucking
traitor. I think Sayori and Monika have been trying really hard to get new members.
I don't think this is how you
do it. The least we can do is help them out a little bit.
This is how they do it. So every club does a thing. Every club does a thing.
It's like a club fair. They're trying to like advertise.
I know, but why would they choose to recite poems? No
one's gonna look.
No, they're having posters there.
Every class does a makes an event. So this is their event.
Stupid. They're the punk club.
It looks like Natsuki doesn't have any arguments left.
Sorry.
Damn.
What was that noise?
It's like a fart.
It's a mouth fart.
Nice.
Yep. Did he just glitch for that for a second?
It's the steam.
That's the steam.
Oh, okay.
You'll be able to tell.
I was like, okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I guess I'll just have to get it over with.
All right.
You. That's Natsuki. What about you, Yuri?
Yuri dejectedly glances at everyone else's expected faces.
Sorry. I guess I don't really have a choice.
Ahaha! That's everyone!
Wait, she's only in.
You're the best, Yuri!
This club is seriously going to be the death of me.
That foreshadowing too?
All of them die.
Well, it's supposed to be a horror game, right?
No, it's an anime.
No, this is the everything's normal.
Anime. Oh gosh, praise gosh.
This is a normal game. We just get
pussy.
It's
a green curtain.
It's fine.
We get all the pussy. You'll be fine, Yuri. But anyway, let's move on to the main event.
4G.
I want each of you to choose a poem of yours. We're going to practice reciting them in front of each other.
Ooh.
Monika! This is too sudden!
Well, if you can't recite your poem in front of the club, how do you expect to do it in front of strangers, you stupid bitch?
Oh no.
Blindness.
Eyes are gone.
Don't worry.
I'll just remove my eyes.
Where are eyes? Where are they? They just crossed the shadow realm.
I love that.
I'll start off to help everyone feel a little more comfortable.
Can I go next?
Oh, but the
flowers! She did the two question marks.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
I was thinking of Shank when he was the ghost.
Shank.
He was a person.
Monika flips through her notebook to the specific poem she has in mind for herself. She then stands behind the podium.
Are we going to see her behind the podium? Nope.
The title of the poem is "The Way They Fly When They Jump Off the Plane."
The way they fly and crash.
Monika began reciting her poem. Her clear, confident voice fills my rectum. More than that, her inflection is pristine. She knows exactly how to apply emotion behind each line she recites, bringing the words to life like a necromancer. Is this something she's done before? Or is she simply a natural?
She was in debate club.
I glance around me. Everyone has their eyes on Monika. Sayori looks amazed. Yuri has an intense expression on her face that I don't understand. Finally, Monika finishes her recitation. The four of us are appalled.
I touched Clara.
Monica takes a breath and smiles.
That was so good, Monica.
Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I was just hoping to sit in your cabin. Are you ready to go next, Sayori?
I'll go next.
Oh man, step it up.
How do I pronounce this?
Like the Norse Chris always says.
You're inspired up all of a sudden.
Yuri clutches her sheet of paper between her thighs and stands up.
This one does.
With her head down, she walks quietly over to the podium. I thought it said quietly, but then it's just
like, she walks like this.
She waddles over to the podium.
My poem is called.
Yuri anxiously glances at each of us.
You can do it, Yuri.
Thanks, bud.
No problem.
It's called After Image of a Crimson Eye.
The fuck? Yuri's voice shakes as she starts reading the incantation. Just a moment ago, she practically refused to do this. Why is she suddenly putting in so much effort?
I want to come.
As Yuri gets past the first couple of lines, her voice changes.
Too demonic.
It's almost like what happens when you're possessed by a demon.
I am seeing Lord Darkness.
Absorbed in her books.
I don't even think I get to read everything.
Her quivering pussy transforms into the sharp syllables of a fierce and confident woman.
Who don't need no man?
You go, girl. The poem is full of twists and turns in its structure, and it's like she wrote the Iliad, damn. And she enunciates perfect timing. This must be a rare glimpse into the whirling fire the Yuri keeps concealed inside her heart. Suddenly, she's vanished. Everyone is paralyzed from the waist down. Yuri snaps her neck into reality and glances around her as if she's bewildered, even herself.
Hi.
And her ghost re-enters her body. It's up to me to save this situation.
No.
I'm the first to start appalling.
Chris, why are you clapping?
Why are you all retarded?
Chris, can you read?
Chris, please clap.
Everyone joins me afterwards. And we give Yuri the recognition she deserves, naming her Chancellor of Germany. It's not that we didn't want to applaud for her.
We just didn't want to.
we just didn't have enough.
Well, we were caught off guard. Now, so off guard that we must have forgotten. As we applaud, Yuri holds the poem to her chest and rushes back into her seat.
Yuri, that was really good. Thank you for sharing.
Looks like Yuri is down for the count.
Man down, man down.
Medic.
Okay. I guess I'm next then.
Sayori hops out of her chair and cheerfully walks to the podium.